this is our idea of our cooperation. I hope that today we will get a campus. I can show you five with some examples, some comments. Yeah. And we might take some help from the focus for the enough class. Before we start, very short about the yesterday. I saw the practice of your of the coach of your national team, Bauerman, and made me very good impression. I don't understand the German, but with the help of my colleagues, I understood everything, and I saw confirmation on the court during the game, Germany against Russia. Especially three quarters of the game, Germany played good defense, some different options in each situation, playing pick and roll, helping, trapping, playing excellent 1-1, and I think that very good opportunity for you to improve yourself, seeing the game, and before you have possibility to get some theoretical information of each different coach. Now, what I yesterday saw as well, two teams, Russia and German, had possibility to play against zone crash and to play against zone defense. And I think that today there is a reason to talk about this zone pressing and to talk about zone offense, how to play against zone pressing and how to play against zone defense. With the help of those guys, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay. My approach, what I prefer to do, this is not the rule, this is not the only one possible way how to play against this situation, but as I always say, maybe you will take some details you will use to your practice, maybe you will use to your games, and probably it will be useful for you. I need 5 players at the beginning. We start setting. Despite what kind of zone pressure you play, I use the same rules what they take the ball with. What we do, this is the most important from the beginning, players have to know. We always make the inbound, out of bounds, on the baseline, with the point guard, come on, here. Never 5 or 4 players do the inbound, because after the pass, it's usually being trapped to the side, one, the second. And if you will get ball back immediately, it will be problems with the dribbling of the pass. If you get pass back to the fight, after this we'll talk later. Okay? Second player is a two-position player who usually receives the ball left or right side. Three player goes to the side, close to the midcourt, but to the side, forward goes at the opposite side, and here, and fighter goes somewhere on the elbow.
the opposite side. Now, my way is to create space maximum as you can. Contract the best dribbler and the second best dribbler makes the first pass. You can move through the baseline as much as you want here. Don't stay on the basket. Yeah. You get four spaces on the pass. And you get it over in one another side. You understand? Just if they try to deny or they just simply and trying to get ready for the draft, you go side, you pass, and immediately you go to the opposite side. Now I'm talking about directional approach. Every draft over here, you get immediately the option for this pass, where is the best your dribbler. If you can pass, you go immediately to the middle and try to split defense zone press to the middle. First day, I talked that we organize, we start our fast break moving the ball to the side. When you play against zone pressure, we never allow to move ball to the side because sideline is like extra player to help. And if you stop the dribble, you cannot pass here, you cannot pass here. You have only one way to pass over the whole court. Never move ball and never move player to the side and never allow him to stop the dribble. That's why you grab, you pass to the side. Let's say we will talk later on the defense. Now, and we have option for the back to stop here. And we stop this dribble. At this time, we put three players inside, come here. We pass out here. Now, and you sprint to this side. Now, five players, depending on situation, moves to the side here. And we create 3-on-2 situation over here. We pass again to the side immediately, or we dribble and we create 2-on-1. Now I will show you again a little bit different. Come on, start saving. Opposite side, we go to the middle here, you sprint, we pass here and run at the opposite side. Now, again, depending on concentration, you move at the opposite side of the ball to bring and go for the pass to the space. Yep, now pass, make a pass, you go here and we have option on the opposite side. We call this press break. This is not option, just to dribble from one side to another side. If you have good enough contact, it sometimes be enough just never let him to trap you, just dribble, okay, be fast, quick, okay, and go to the middle and set your offense. But if you want to punish and you have already good organization, you can do this with the excellent moving and passing what I showed. Drive on the back. Now, check out at the opposite side here. Okay, pass, go inside, middle. Okay, stop. Middle, yeah. Now we pass back. We have to stay here and middle goes here. Okay. We create 2-on-1. Now, come here. And we need 5 players in the defense. If can we change colors a little bit? Light and dark. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. time talking, talking. Let's start to play numbers. Okay. What kind of defense we have? 1, 2, 1, 1. Let's say like this. Later we will change. 2, 2, and 1. Okay. And we will see how it works and what is the weakest point in each situation when we start with this defense. Okay. 1, 2, and 1 to the middle. Okay. And 1 at the opposite side. Okay. Yeah. Now, zone pressure. You allow to receive the ball. Make inbound. Immediately, track which side? This side. Look, we have one option to this side. Yeah? We have one option to the side and we do this pass. Immediately, when he gets the ball, make the pass, he goes to the middle. We have second option going to the middle and we have option for this pass. Next, get back. Receive the ball here, okay? Now, you demand this pass. What is possible also here, we have quick option for this pass. Now, one more time, get back. Get open, yeah. You deny this option, yeah. You deny the middle with the pass. We have option here, yeah. You can run and you can create. We have advantage. 1, 2, 3 players against 2. Now, let's start with 2, 2, and 1. Pay every focus more attention and you will remember the situation on the game when those two guys trying to deny first pass. They not allowed to receive the first pass. Yeah? And it's being sometimes complicated to make the inbound. Yeah? You go one side, you deny it. Yeah? Go. Yeah? You go at the opposite side. Yeah? Go at the opposite side. They deny it. Yeah? And you have to move one of the second left. Now, they say, coach, it's really very difficult to get open. Believe me, coaches, this is not difficult to get open. Because some players doesn't know their abilities. If they deny this pass, just turn around and sprint here. It's impossible that this open space to be denied. Okay, let's try. No pass here. Yeah, and we move one player here. Now, front, okay, he cut. Okay, no pass. You go at the opposite side and make pass over. And what we have, 3 against 2. One more time. Now, recognize this player and you are waiting behind. You're not allowed to make it pass. Now, just one step up front, you go to the side, after the pass, yeah, immediately cut and receive the ball, and go to the middle, creating again 3 against 2. The rule, always to the middle, 3, 2, or 1. Now, let's try this. Not maximum effort, just normally, simply, remember. And understand it. Let's go. Okay. Stop. Come fast, okay, just cut, go. power and to stop last in those six zones. Yeah? My rule and idea is that key player must always receive the ball and the key player must find the weakest point of the defense. In zone 2-3, okay, we usually start offense playing 5 and 4 and the corners of the thing. And as our life shows that the weakest point of this defense is here on the free throw line, on the high post. And as fast as possible, we try to pass ball here on the high post. Yeah? Sometimes you can just simply pass and look for this player. But it's easier when those big guys know that sprinting and getting over time is the most essential thing. Take the ball back. Yeah? After this pass to the side, we go to the middle for the pass. At the same time, when you get the ball, we spread the defense going to this side. Four. It's a very good idea when we have shooter here. Four shooters. Four, when four can shoot outside. This is a perfect idea. At the same time, you can always decide to start from the beginning. There's always the take you are here. We pass. Decide again. And now, no. Five guys. And go at the opposite side. Now, if they try to help from the side, for sure it will be open. But you can shoot. You did right, but don't forget that this is your bet. Now, if they do mistake, yeah, and they allow to receive the ball, then they do receive the ball go up. Yeah. Now, this player is getting a key player has three different options. First option for sure is to shoot. To shoot. And at the same time, five defensive players goes up and you cut to the baseline. Yeah? You cut to the baseline, take one player. Yeah? I always see that this player is hesitating. He doesn't know to stay with him or he must to cut. Playing regular game. At the same time, we have wing player who goes to the corner. Yeah? This player, believe me, playing regular zone is always hesitating to go to the corner or to stay here. Now, if you have excellent defense, who is coming and following this player, it will be not zone. It will be man to man. Look, you go baseline, okay? Yeah? You go corner. This is not something. Yeah? You split, you give ball back and you play negative role. But this is future. But if you play regular zone, get back, yeah? Start from the middle, start down, and you play fast with a very good understanding. For sure, you will get pass to the baseline and you will make pass to the corner. Let's go. Okay? Pass to the M side, okay? Pass as one. Okay? I can ball here, okay? Always when you can do this too. Now, baseline cut, yeah? Okay. The zone, your zone is here, okay? Who is it? You help this guy in the zone? Already. Yeah. You see, sample, but very based on that you have gone. If you stop that, it will be based on corner. If you stop based on that, if you stop based on that, it will be corner home. Now, continuing to do this, okay, we make some extra options. Come on, yeah. Let's start from the beginning. Okay, stop. Start from the beginning. Okay? Stay patient. Okay? Let's go. Side. Okay? Now. They not only denied him. They use the five player who is really stop pass to the paint. To the high post. We never move five player higher than the free throw line. He just going toward the ball, yeah, but he was stuck on the time. We pass ball to the corner, yeah, and now we do the same action. We move to the one zone. You touch inside, yeah. You go in this zone. Now, tell me please, is it possible to stop one player in the zone and at the same time stop this player? I think now possible. If you will stay here, okay, and he will cut, I will be here asking for the ball. Now watch practically how it looks. Okay? Start from the beginning. We will do later non-stop from the beginning to the end. But now explanation here what I want. Yeah? Now. Pass to the side, yeah? Pass to the corner, you cut, now, go, and make the pass here, now, corner is open, yeah? Where is your, okay, one more time? Okay, side, here, to the left, now, at the same time, when you get the ball, the big guy must cut and ask for the ball. This player is always in that not best, believe me. And this is really complicated to switch what you do. But let's go. Side. Okay. Okay. Pass. And cut. Pass. Option for the left and option for the pass. And if you didn't pass here, okay, or you have situation come back like this, make pass, what is also possible, make pass here, okay, to the side, then, and cut, okay, your wide is open, you cannot stay alone, guys. Okay, you have to come here, okay, and you have to take the court. Okay? Sure, this is not possible. Here. Now, pass to the middle. Okay? Now, pass for the open back. Yeah? If you just protect him from the top, watch this guy. Court vision! Four players outside really pays much maximum importance. After this test, you cannot pass inside. Come here, okay? You go to this side. Go at the opposite side. If you do not receive the ball, go to the rear, okay? And pass ball to the rear. Again, we rotate 1, 2, 3, 4 players at the different zones. Yet we pass to the middle. We pass to the side, and we try to pass here at the right wall. Now, very good situation. We get one player open, because he's going down. And top left, try to stop that right wall. We have option for this pass and for this pass. Yeah? And when he gets the ball, we go to the baseline. No go to the corner, and we try to pass and to pass again and move compartments on the opposite side. Okay? Start from the beginning. Watch what I said. And each one is important. If we can pass high post, do this. If we cannot pass, pass to the side. If we cannot pass, yep, pass again and restart from the opposite side. Okay, ready. Okay, good. Second time, but you run perfectly. You keep kept playing normal space, good passing, and good understanding. I will back and you will stop. Stressing where is a good open possibility for the shot. Okay? Okay. One. Stop. 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 In this case, when you stop this letter, okay? This cut. Yeah, must be most important. Five goes up, cut, ask for the ball, and this moment five is already switched on this player. We have option for this pass. And if they stop him on the opposite side, okay, we have option for this skip pass. It's not so easy. Yeah, and some teams playing like smooth. This version and you can pass. But simply not if they try to protect the pass here and shoot out. Okay, from the beginning or the side.
After you get the ball, yeah, you have option from the shot.
now. But everyone can do the speed. Everybody can do what I saw yesterday in those Super Cup 40s. Next, watch the baseline. Turn, watch the corner and watch the opposite side. Fiber into his heart, okay, too late, and he will open the baseline. If those guys will try to protect you, we will get one pass and another pass. For open shot, we have players outside. Believe me, and we have to use them, watch them outside. Okay, one more time, one more time.
To know the system and to watch open player and to
shoot when we get over. Okay, let's go now. Two power toss, non-stop, pass to the side. Side, you see the ball, we go here. Okay, up, power toss, up, stand. We do the same from the opposite side. Okay, ready. Stop, stop, stop! Okay, stop.
Thank you.
agree or not, but this is my opinion, what I like. Okay, let's go and start one more time trying to make out of bounds.
Thank you.
a lot of times. And what teams usually play, and yesterday they did, using the pick and roll, playing against zone. This is also all right if you have shooter at the point guard, if you have shooters, the 2-3 position, I do the same and I like this, but my first option is like this. If you do it correctly, it's very, very difficult to stop. It's being that you cannot make it. Yeah. It's being daylight, you cannot. You shoot open, yeah. Your opponent feels very confident psychologically that you make this and they can really stop you with the zone defense. But if you do it properly, correctly, a lot of options try you will get. But sometimes it helps. Very simple option playing the pick and roll. Come on, start from the beginning. What we did, yeah, pass slowly, pass to the side, pass to the corner, cut, cut, receive the ball here, pass to the middle. Now, next to the corner again, cut. We create the same options for every one player. And now, after this test, we have two or one for very good situation playing in row. Make defense, get immediately, and now, how the defense react. Yep. They will switch to this one player who will switch on him. They will switch to this guy. Yeah, you will test and you will use this quarter player. Okay? One more time from the beginning. Using this defense. Okay. No pass. Defense can choose everything what they want. They cannot switch those two players. They can involve big guys, like regular defense against pick and roll. Yesterday you saw how to defend against pick and roll. Yeah. Today I will show how to play offensive pick and roll playing zone. Let's go. Let's start from the beginning. Yeah. Same. Against hand, they go to one side, yeah? No, yeah.
This is true. And the big guy is waiting down. Let's say he's sitting down. What we do? We do again the regular rules like against man to man. I look at the swing, yeah? It's better on the front. It's better on the front. I work swing. Go for the penetration, okay? Try split defense and to pass. This is dependent on your body. Okay? Try one more time. Use the big guy help. No help from the top. Big guy help inside. Ready?
Possible to the corner.
If it's not possible to pass here, okay?
Yes. If you play that a few times, maybe the opposite coach will try that this pass is not possible.
Yeah. This is a very good question, and very often you do this. Yeah, we do this way. You cannot pass. That's why I say use the both sides. One and another side. Yeah? And ball must be moved from one to another side. And if you do not pass here, immediately go on the opposite side. Because this leg will be right at this leg. And just simply move and it will be rotation in this and try to pass to this side. You understand?
Yeah, my next problem is this, the four. The guy who's four has to be an excellent passer. This is a big man you have there in the corner, and he has to he has to pass excellent. And very, very often you don't have that.
Sorry, one more time. You four cannot pass.
Not good enough because that has to be a good passer. Special for the inside pass. For the first, your first touch.
Yeah, I understand. To run this system, how to say, you have at least to have well prepared and to work not 15 minutes to the end. What we usually, I do the same because we don't practice enough playing zone defense and playing zone offense. we only give like 20 maximum or 15 minutes at the end of the practice how to run against zone. Because if we really play zone offense, it not depends on us, mostly depends on the opponent. And we play 10 games in a row and nobody plays zone defense. That's why we cannot practice and improve ourselves every day. And people forgetting what we have really to do. But the four position pass and he has to be the host. It's very good. In the Lithuanian national team we have really good possibility. We have good choice. We have Lavrinovic, we have Songaila, we have twin brothers, Lavrinovic, who are excellent shooters. We have Songaila, who played in NBA, and we have Klaser. All of them excellent shooters and good passes. That's why we can run easy with this system. And no, I don't want to say that you can do this only with a perfect players. Believe me, you can do with the three shooters. And my goal was not to prove that we run only in Lithuania with some Sabonis or some other. No, this is explanation what I like for the juniors also. Now, believe me, your defense will never be so perfect. I mean opponent's defense. After the pass, yeah, you will get option for this test or for this test. And after you see Michael, sometimes it's enough to have good power forward who played excellent under the basket. He got inside, he sealed the back, and he got the ball because five is going to come. After the pass, he will make the left. Sometimes it's enough. I use several options, not for the shot, but for complex situations.
Okay, for working with junior players, where I come from, most of the kids start with 8 or 10 years old just playing basketball. Which age of the players would you start with such a system? How old do they have to be to understand it as a player?
If I would have a power, I will forbid to play. In Lithuania will be forbidden to play zone defense. Believe me, zone defense will not help to improve your players individually. You see, passing, shooting on the three-point line, very simple decisions and so on. I prefer that my players will know how to dribble the ball, how to penetrate with the left, with the right, how to make fake, how to read situation, and we have big problem. We losing a lot of players because in Lithuania it's allowed too early to play zone defense. From 8 to 12 it's also forbidden. It's not allowed. Referees, if you have junior game, they watch it. Zone defense, technical foul, and you have like in NBA before to start to play man-to-man defense. But from 12 or from 13 years, it's allowed. And players know, a lot of players are raised tough, but individually, they don't develop themselves. That's my answer.
Next question. You just mentioned the penetration. Do you allow the penetration while you're playing against them? Obviously, you didn't mention it before.
Penetration is not forbidden. This is a basketball. But if you penetrate immediately, believe me, the zone defense is a help defense. You have always five players inside. And nobody, if we run this system, is ready. As I told first, the second day, that the penetration, everybody must be ready. You have to create good spacing and good angles. Five players is over here. You penetrate, defensive five is inside. How you can pass if you will be in front. Five help, everybody tonight, you will go straight to the player, turnover, and then. Not forbidden. If you succeed, do this. if you see that they too wide and they don't control the level. But the better is to run and to find solution for the show.
And when I watched the German team yesterday, they had a big problem playing against some defense because they had full shooters on them. And if you have full shooters, like for example yesterday, you've got to penetrate, you have to protect the basketball.
For sure, if I would be a coach of the team who is really knows that your opponent is a full shooter, I will set the zone defense. Very compact, very close to the zone defense. And I will tell you one situation. The Lithuanian national team 2 years ago beat, no, 3 years ago, at the Olympic Games beat United States national team. Maybe you remember too this. They play very compact, very close to the paint zone defense. And Americans tries only to penetrate. They put Carmelo Anthony, Iverson outside the paint, outside the 3-point line, yeah, and everybody tried to shoot open, but they couldn't make it. But they shoot open, and if they score, for sure they did. No, we will not talk about successful defense. Now they were successful.
What was the different option between good shooter on the floor or bad shooter? You do not have a good shooter on the floor.
No. If you have four perfect shooter, you will get much more options, for sure.
No.
Yeah. But when we run the second over top, everybody react on the player who moves the corner. Everybody move. If they don't move on your shooter, this is excellent. But they move.
Does it work against a 3-2 zone?
Yes. Yes. Works especially with this cut inside. Overload, they have to switch the results. It works. Okay. Thank you very much. It was a big pleasure to cooperate with you during those 3 days. I hope that for some coaches we'll meet again somewhere, and I wish you all the best in your career, in your teams, working very, very tough, very hard job. Thank you very much.